Connection Kids, what's up? It's Pastor Tyler. Time for Bible trivia! We read about the birth of Jesus in the book of Matthew. We read about the birth of Jesus in the book of Matthew. False. Luke chapter 2. The angel Gabriel appeared to tell Mary that she was with child. The angel Gabriel appeared to tell Mary that she was with child. True. Jesus was born in the city of Bethlehem. Jesus was born in the city of Bethlehem. True. Mary and Joseph traveled 10 miles to get to Bethlehem. Mary and Joseph traveled 10 miles to get to Bethlehem. False. It was 80 miles. A manger is a barn that houses animals. A manger is a barn that houses animals. False. A feeding trough. The prophet Isaiah foretold a virgin shall give birth to a son called Emmanuel. The prophet Isaiah foretold a virgin shall give birth to a son called Emmanuel. True. The Bible says Jesus was born in December. The Bible says Jesus was born in December. False. All of Bethlehem came to see Jesus the night he was born. All of Bethlehem came to see Jesus the night he was born. False. Only the shepherds. The three wise men were not present at Jesus' birth. The three wise men were not present at Jesus' birth. True. King John was the one trying to kill baby Jesus. King John was the one trying to kill baby Jesus. False. King Herod. The name Emmanuel means blessed one. The name Emmanuel means blessed one. False. God with us. Christmas wasn't celebrated for over 300 years after Jesus died. Christmas wasn't celebrated for over 300 years after Jesus died. True, the first Christmas was celebrated on December 25th, 336 AD. Tyler, and welcome to Connection Kids Christmas Eve service. How many of you are super duper excited to be here? I know I am, and I'm so excited for Christmas time. So, here's what I want you to do. I want you to turn to the left. This is Pastor Tyler's left, and maybe your mom, your dad, your grandma, your grandpa, your brother, or a pillow, or your dog, and I want you to say, Merry Christmas! Go! Now, I want you to turn to the right, and whoever's over there, I want you to say, Merry Christmas! Go! Merry Christmas! Now, I want you to look up front and say, You look good. Go! Guys, wow, that was way too nice. Thank you, thank you. I'm so excited to be here. Yes, my hair is growing back. Maybe it's your first time at Connection Kids, or maybe you've been here 597 times. Let us know in the comments below, because we have a team who wants to say hi and Merry Christmas to all of you. Today is going to be an amazing day as we are celebrating the birth of Jesus. Yes, we're celebrating the birth of Jesus. And in our service, we have an amazing Nativity Gingerbread Candy Competition. We have a Christmas craft with Miss Marie. And then 26 of our friends helped us as we made an ABC alphabet Christmas story version. So letters A to Z, the Christmas story will be told by our friends. And we're so excited as we are celebrating the birth of Jesus. And we're going to look at the nativity scene today. So boys and girls, I don't know about you, but Pastor Tyler is super excited because we love to connect to each other. But most importantly, we love to connect to Jesus. So we're going to have tons of fun. And if you're ready to go, put it in the comments below. I am ready for today. So boys and girls, buckle up and let's go jump into our service.
Hello, my name is Paisley Piper, and we have the letter A. A is for an angel Gabriel who began the story with a greeting. Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people.
Hi, I'm Maddie.
And I'm Tucka.
Our letter is B. B is for Bethlehem.
Where our stories takes place.
People traveled from far and wide to arrive in the city.
It was a very busy place.
Hello, my name is Allison. And the letter I have is C. C is for census. That's the counting of all the people, which was the reason why so many people filled the city of Bethlehem.
Hi, I'm William, and I'm Sadie, and we have the letter G. G is for donkey, that's Hairy Mary and the baby, on a long journey to Bethlehem to be counted in the census.
Hello, my name is Natalie, and I have the letter E. E is for exhausted. That's how everyone felt when they arrived, tired from all the traveling.
Our names are Aaron,
Caleb,
and Max.
We have the level F.
F is for family. Mary and Joseph and their newborn baby, Jesus, who was born in
Bethlehem, like first Christmas. Christmas is a great time to remember how important our family is to us.
Hey everyone, it's Pastor Tyler, and we are doing a candy nativity scene challenge. Over here we have Ava, and over here we have Miss Marie, and they are going to build nativity scenes out of candy, and you get to vote which one is the best. They have all kinds of delicious candy that I can't wait to eat. So, do you think Ava's gonna win, or do you think Miss Marie's gonna win? Get ready on three, and you guys get to see the amazing nativity scene they make out of candy. One, two, three, go, go, go! Let's take a look at her amazing candy nativity scene, and she's going to explain to us. Let's take a look.
So.
Wow.
This is baby Jesus. I ate his like body so he would look like smaller than all my other kids. Well, Sour Patch Kids.
Okay.
This is the Kit Kat bar is the, no, the Twix, no, yeah. The Twix bar is the state, like the manger.
Okay.
This is Joseph and Mary.
All right, let's get a closer look. Everyone, look at Ava's nativity. Right now, you vote if you think Ava is the winner candy dinner.
Okay, so I have snow. I have all the important people. I've got the sheep and the shepherd. I've got Mary. No, that's Joseph. That's the gum is Joseph. That is Mary. This is baby Jesus. I have Christmas lights. You can hang a plant on that.
Wow.
You just move in and you could eat. As you were living there.
You can move in, but there is no roof. All right, so are you gonna vote for Miss Marie right here? Or are you gonna vote for Miss Ava right here?
Oh yeah.
Tell us in the comments below and we will see who the winner candy dinner is. Everyone give a big round of applause for Miss Marie and Miss Ava. Awesome.
Hi. My name is Priscilla, and I have the letter G. G is for good news. Good news for all the people. That is what the angel said. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. That's good news.
Hello, my name is Rachel, and I have the letter H. H is for hurting all the animals that were present in the stable, and the flocks of sheep in the field with the shepherds when they heard the good news.
Hi, my name is Luke.
Hi, my name is Zoe, and our letter is I.
I is for illumination.
Jesus came to be a light in the darkness.
And we are reminded to let our
light illuminate the darkness in our
world today.
My name is Jonah, and I have the letter J. J is for joy, excitement, and happiness that a new baby brings, but also for the joy of saving grace that he shares with the entire world.
Hello, my name is Carolyn. My letter is K. K is for kindness shown by the innkeeper that night, allowing a tired family to stay in the stable when there was no room in the inn.
Hi guys, my name is Laura, and my letter is L. And L is for the love that we share all year round, and especially at Christmas.
Hello, my name's Maya.
And I'm Marilla.
We have the letter M. M stands for manger. It is usually used to hold food for animals, but this time it held the baby. because he had no crib.
Hi, I'm Miss Marie, and we're going to make a Christmas craft together today. We're going to make an ornament that's sparkly and you can hang it on your tree. But first, I'd like you to think a minute about your favorite ornament that you have at home and comment about it and tell us why it's your favorite. One of my favorite ornaments are those little gingerbread men that smell like cinnamon that my kids made in preschool. The ornament we're gonna make today is this candy cane that you can hang on your tree. And don't eat this one because it's fuzzy. If you want a candy cane you can eat, you can look in your Christmas Eve bag from Connection Kids and you will find one in there. But that's not what we're gonna use for our ornament today. So you're gonna take two of the pipe cleaners out of your bag. And you can start making your ornament by taking these pipe cleaners and holding them up next to each other so that they're even. And you can twist them together at the top. You wanna twist them good so that they stay together. And then you can turn the pipe cleaners on the side. And you are gonna wrap them around each other so you can see both the colors. And you can take your time and wrap them nice and tight. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that while you do yours. I love how the two colors stand out like a real candy cane. Once you are done, you're going to take the pipe cleaners and fold it in half, and then you can twist them together again. And you can curve the pipe cleaners and shape it into a candy cane. And there you go, great job. And if you'd like to do it again, there are two more pipe cleaners in your bag. The other craft stuff you wanna save because we have something else exciting coming up. Merry Christmas.
Hi, my name is Zoe.
And our letter is N.
N is for Noel. Another word for Christmas. It means new birth. That is what happened in the Christmas story. And Jesus can bring us new life every day of the year.
Hi, I'm Christopher and I got the letter O, my favorite letter. O stands for octopus, but in this case it stands for offering. The three wise men gave an offering of gold, frankincense, and myrrh to Jesus. We can give an offering of our gifts, talents, and time as an offering to God.
He is for prayer, praise, and pondering. All different ways people react to the amazing things that happen as part of Christ's birth. Remember to pray, praise, and ponder together as a family this year.
Hello, my name is Matea. I have the letter Q. Q is for quiet, the deepest peace that Christmas brings, knowing that God is with us.
Hi, my name is Chloe.
And I'm Emily. We have the letter R. R is for revelation.
God revealed to us that he had not forgotten his people and showed us love by sending his one and only son, God, to be with us.
Hello, my name is JoJo.
And my name is Fiona.
S is for one special star that's showing right in the night, showing wise ones the way to Jesus.
Well, my name is Arin, and I have the letter D. T is for trust, the confidence we have in God.
At Connection Kids, we love to connect to Jesus. So I want you guys to join me right now as we worship the Lord together. We're gonna sing Joy to the World. So I want you boys and girls to have joy as we sing this song and worship Jesus together. So join me, sing loud at home, and let's praise Jesus right now.
my name is Ava. What worship means to me is spending time with God. It connects my heart to Jesus. So join me in singing Silent Night. Let's worship together.
It's Pastor Tyler, and I am so excited as we have been celebrating the birth of Jesus. Now, how many of you at home have a nativity scene? Maybe under the Christmas tree? And every time you see it, it should remind you to celebrate the birth of Jesus. And so right now, I need all of you to go to your Christmas Eve experience kits as we're about to do an interactive Bible story where I need all of your help as we get to tell this amazing story. So, open up your bags, and you should find a piece of paper, and you should find a bell that was attached to the paper. We'll need that for the Bible story, and then your bag of supplies. So, do you guys all have your bag of supplies? As we're gonna tell the nativity story, and you guys get to glue it on the paper as I tell it, and I'm so excited. So, I can't wait to see yours afterwards, because I'm sure it's gonna look better than Pastor Tyler's. So I need everyone right now to get their popsicle sticks and their glue stick and to build a stable in the middle of the page. Can you do that? All right, I'm gonna do it too. So build a stable in the middle of the page. Let's make sure it looks really nice. And while we're doing that, who can tell me in the comments below, or you can shout it out, Who are some of the people in the nativity story? Let me hear you. That's right. The shepherds, good. Who else? Wise men, Mary, Joseph, baby Jesus, great. So while you're doing this fable, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about Mary. You see, Mary was visited by an angel, and the angel went and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you." Mary was troubled and a little startled, but the angel said, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God." And then he said this, "You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and he will reign over forever. His kingdom will never end." And Mary, she was a little confused, and she asked the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel replied and said this, "For the child within you was conceived by the Holy Spirit." And how did Mary respond? Mary obeyed and she followed God's plan. So I want you to get your marker. Oh, you all have different colors. I have yellow, awesome. And in the stable, I want you to draw Mary on one of the sides. Draw Mary, I'm not a great drawer, but I'll try my best. Okay, I drew Mary, great. Now, let's talk about Joseph. So right now, you should have the stable and you should have drawn Mary. Let's talk about Joseph. And we're gonna read this from Matthew chapter 1. So this is how Jesus the Messiah was born. His mother, Mary, was engaged to be married to Joseph. But before the marriage took place, while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant through the power of the Holy Spirit. Joseph, to whom she was engaged, was a righteous man, and he did not want to disgrace her publicly, so he decided to break off the engagement quickly. As he considered this, guess what? An angel appeared to him, and the angel said this, "Do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit. And she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." So what did God ask Joseph to do? To take Mary as his wife, even though she was with child. And did he listen? Yes, he did. So right now in the stable, I want you to draw Joseph. All right, so you have Mary, Joseph, and the stable. I can't wait to see yours afterwards. So earlier, a couple of our friends have been telling the Bible story with the alphabet. And so remember B. B is for Bethlehem, where our story takes place. People traveled from far and wide to arrive in the city. It was a very busy place. C is for census. That's a counting of all the people, which is the reason why Mary and Joseph had to go there. And then D is for the donkey that carried Mary and her baby on their long journey. So Mary was on a donkey and Joseph, and they went to Bethlehem and they tried to find a place, but all that was left was this stable. So while I tell you the next part, I want you guys to get baby Jesus in this part. So in your bag, you'll see two things. You will see little baby Jesus, and then you'll see this is the cloth that he was wrapped in. And in his manger, we're gonna put some hay to make it comfortable. So you see this? This is the hay. So I want you guys to glue the hay and then put baby Jesus on. So let's do this together. I'm excited to do it. I can't wait to see what yours looks like. Okay, here we go. Are you guys doing it? You getting it? Yours is probably gonna look a little better than mine. Okay, so Jesus was born in a stable because there was no room for him to be born in the inn. And so here we have Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus. So let's turn to Luke chapter 2, verse 6. It says this, "While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger. And then Matthew 1:21 says this, she will give birth to a son and you are to give him the name Jesus because he will save his people from their sins. So boys and girls, Jesus was born. Jesus was born in this stable, in a manger that had hay and there were animals all around. Jesus was born. Now, let's talk about someone who came to visit baby Jesus. This person, I gotta be honest, they probably smelled a little bit. Does anyone know who it was? That's right, the shepherds. Shepherds were always taking care of their sheep. And I don't know if you've ever been around a sheep, but they smelly. So go in your bag and you will find two cotton balls. These will be our two little sheep. So get the glue stick and on either side of the stable, I want you to glue the sheep. And while you're doing that, I want to share this with you. That night, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified, the sheep and the shepherd. They were all terrified. But the angel said, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people." What is it? Here it is. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem. So that's great news, right? And the angel said this, "You will find a baby wrapped in cloth, lying in a manger." And then suddenly, an angel was joined by a lot of other angels. So in the one corner, I want you to get your marker and I want you to draw, let's do like three angels. I'm not sure how to draw angels. I'm doing my best here, guys. All right, let's draw three angels. I want to see what you guys come up with. And so, as you can imagine, there's a bunch of angels. And okay, are you good? You got your angels? Grab your bell. Here we go. And the angels began praising God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased." They began rejoicing and praising God. And the shepherds were so excited that they said, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see what has happened. Let's see the Messiah, the Savior." And they went. And there they saw a baby lying in the manger. How awesome is that? And they began to praise Jesus. And they were celebrating the birth of Jesus. Now, there's someone else we haven't talked about. Do you know who we're missing in the story? That's correct, the wise men. So I want everyone to get this out of your bag. This is a gold coin that is fake. Now, the wise men would have been known today as astronomers. They studied the stars. Now, the wise men, they heard about baby Jesus, and King Herod was like, remember King Herod? He was real upset. He was like, "Ooh, tell me where baby Jesus is so I can go worship him." But King Herod had different plans. So the wise men went and they followed the star. So you guys see this star? I want you to get your star. I want you to unwrap it and put it in the one corner. All right? So put your star. And while you're doing that, I want to explain a little more about the wise men. The wise men went. They followed the star. And I want to tell you this. The wise men actually didn't go to the stable right when Jesus was born. This was a little time after when the wise men visited Jesus. He was a little older and they went and visited him and they began to worship him and they gave him gold. And so I want you to glue that on your one side of the paper to remember the wise men. So boys and girls, look at that paper you just did. I want you to look at it. I'm looking at mine. When we see this, we remember to celebrate the birth of Jesus, right? We see the sheep, which reminds us of the shepherds and how the angel spoke to them and said, "Good news, that will be great joy to all people. The Messiah, the Savior, was born today." Right? We see Mary and Joseph who followed God's plan. And boys and girls, I love this story. It's the greatest story. because Jesus came to save us from our sins. He came as a little baby to this earth to be our Messiah, to be our Savior. And so, boys and girls, maybe some of you are out there and like, Pastor Tyler, I've accepted Jesus into my life. I have a relationship with Jesus. And boys and girls, I am so happy to hear that. Now, some of you out there are like, I want a relationship with Jesus. I want Jesus to be my Savior, my Messiah, my best friend, my leader, my King. And guess what, boys and girls? Jesus loves us so much that all we have to do is ask and ask for forgiveness of our sins. And we can have a relationship with Him. And boys and girls, I remember when I was 8 years old hearing this story and how Jesus came to be the Savior. And how years later He died on the cross for me. And I remember that moment when I accepted Him into my heart. And I want the greatest gift of all time to be shared with you. So if you want to make that decision, I want you to repeat this prayer after me. And if you've already said it before, you can repeat after me too. So let's pray together. Say, Jesus, we love you. Thank you for coming to the earth as a baby. Thank you for being our Savior. Lord, I know I have sinned. I repent of those sins. And I invite you into my heart. Jesus, I love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Boys and girls, if you made that decision for the first time, let us know as we want to connect with you. And it's an amazing day. And remember today that we are celebrating that Jesus was born.
Hello, my name is Ryan, and I have the letter U. U is for unity. All different people from all different backgrounds brought together to celebrate God's love.
Hello, my name is Ava, and I have the letter V. V is for vulnerable. Jesus was a little child that needed to be cared for. There are many people in this world who are feeling vulnerable right now, and our job as followers of Christ is to help care for them and love them.
Hi, my name's Miss Sandy, and I got the letter W. W is for wonder and our amazement at the beauty of how much God loves us that He would send His Son to be with us.
Hello, my name is Karis, and I have the letter X. X is for Xmas. Did you know that the X is actually the symbol for Christ, and it is the first letter of the Greek word for Christ?
Hi, my name is Dylan. The letter I'm doing is Y. Y is for you, even if you're the only person on earth. Jesus would go down from heaven to die on the cross for you.
Hi, my name is Georgie, and I have the letter Z. Z is for zeal, the passion with which we share the good news and God's love, today and all throughout the year.
And today, if you made a decision to follow Jesus, let us know as we'd love to connect with you. Well, boys and girls, we love you guys. We're praying for you. My son TJ just wanted to say hi. Can you say hi to everyone? Awesome. We love you guys. We hope you had a great day, and we want to wish you a Merry Christmas. And we hope to see you next week online as we're going to have a great service together. Bye, everybody. Bye-bye.